Yo, did you catch this flashback?
Did you guys see this in real life last night? Yeah, my son has that Flava Flav clock, the one that he wears around his neck, the one of Flav holding a clock. He has that in his bathroom. Every time I see he and Bridget kiss or do something, I always wonder what his breath smells like.
Got him. This is it right here.
Miss a day, miss a whole lot.
Oh, shoot.
Do you speak his voice? It's Wendy, man.
Rock and roll, honey.
Hi.
Oh, you're the one who opened up the Some Pousse drink. Mm-hmm. You are Rick's daughter.
He said he was going to use
that. Drinking Some Pousse. That has been sitting around there. Hey, it's very nice to meet you.
You too.
That drink has been sitting around the office for a few days now. Everybody just kind of looks at it and is like, ew, here, have a seat. Have a seat.
I asked them for an energy drink. I needed a Red Bull.
But does it taste like fish?
Or something. It's good.
Oh, is it?
It's actually, it's good.
There's a stripper on the bottle and everything. It's one of those energy drinks, you all. It's called Some Pousse.
From Columbus.
Mm-hmm.
Columbus, Ohio.
So anyway, everybody, James, Ty, you know what? Because I want to say Tay-Tay. Mm-hmm. You know, the Ali girls have come through the show. And it's just a daughter of a legend type thing I have in my mind. Now, your father, Rick, you guys, The Estate, has a new CD coming out on Sanctuary Records called
ma'am.
Rick James, bitch.
Rick James forever.
Bitch. Wonderful. Right. Ty, wait, come up to the microphone just a little bit more or just, you know, wiggle the microphone around. All right. Ty's got the fly rock and roll blonde, like T-Boz from TLC blonde. How old are you, honey? Or what's your showbiz age?
Let's go. Let me see.
We look
anywhere between 20 and 25.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we'll take it there.
Okay. All right.
Now, I have two. I have two daughters, so I'm pushing 30, and I don't really have a problem saying that.
I got you. Now your siblings. You have Rick James Jr.
Mm-hmm.
He's older than you.
No, he's younger than me.
Are you the oldest?
I'm the oldest
of the James
girl
kids?
And his two boys.
And how old are the boys?
Tasman is 13, and then little Ricky is like 28, 29, something.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. So. Now, Ty is here, everybody. First of all, you're here with a man who is acting as producer of your father's story that you guys want to go on the big screen, which, in my opinion, will be as big as Ray. I hate to compare it to Ray because they're both legends and fabulous men in their own rights.
Uh-huh.
But this has got to be done and done correctly.
Right.
Who, Ty, would you love to play your father?
Here we go. I would like to see Terrence Howard. I would like to see
You know him. What? He could pull it off.
He can definitely pull it off. He needs something big. He's had so much success, but he hasn't had anything that I feel like he's been passionate about.
He doesn't look anything
about.
Like your father, but you know what?
Yeah,
they can work
does.
That over. And
he God.
Does?
Yeah.
I'm trying to think. I love him,
light
though.
Light skin, light eyes, very handsome guy.
Your father's brown skin.
No.
What's brown skin with blue without brown eyes?
No, he's my complexion. My dad is light. He might be lighter than me.
Was light.
Well, I still kind of...
Wait a minute. Art, why are you dinging?
No,
you think that Terrence Howard could play Rick James?
Oh, no doubt. I mean,
no, I'm talking about the looks.
Yeah.
I think that
you got to see a recent picture of not, you know, TV.
Yeah.
Because he's definitely lighter.
Whatever. They work over all that in the wardrobe department.
Yeah.
But as far as the acting chops, I think that he could do it definitely.
He's
and
the
I like
shit.
Him a lot. Excuse me. I like him a lot. So now what are you here promoting today other than, are we opening up casting? What are we doing? What is that over there ringing? Is that your phone ringing? What is that? Cassidy, I'm a Hustle on your phone? I hear that. Is that the Mary Jane remix?
Stay grounded. I'm grinding.
Where
right
do you
now.
Live, Ty?
I'm in Cali.
And so you have your two children,
mm-hmm.
and are you luxuriating off your father's estate?
Not at all. I wish I could say that, really, because he worked hard as hell for his children and his family to be able to do that. But no, that's not
the
case.
Did you hear about the estate of Lamont Bentley? Lamont Bentley left behind $21 million. How much money did your father leave behind?
We don't even know. Honestly, the state is still, you know, still going through probate, and it's a lot of things that
How much money is on the table, approximately? I mean, you should at least know that.
No, not really. I don't, because he generates a certain amount a year, so that's like maybe a few million, but I don't have specific numbers.
Okay, well, like ballpark, like how many properties did he have? I mean, you would at least know, okay, Dad had 7 different houses that we know of. And dad had $350,000 in
a
savings, and
then there's a home in Buffalo. But it wasn't like he had a lot of property.
Okay. What about cash in the bank? And when I say that, I mean like, a cap account, a stock portfolio, just general cash laying around?
It's hard to say, Wendy. I really don't.
The majority of your father's living was being done off of checks that would come in per month, off of, what do you call that, Art?
Royalty
checks,
publishing.
Yeah.
A lot of it, yeah. But he has accountants that basically run his finances.
Okay, as the oldest child, do you feel as though, you know, you should be on top of the accountants who could very well be robbing you and your siblings and your children
most
blind?
Definitely, yeah. That has came up. That issue has came up. So,
because your dad passed how long ago?
August 6th of last year.
Okay, so it's been not quite a year.
Close to a year, right.
When do you anticipate this will all be? I mean, is it going to be a dreamy Christmas for the James kids and grandchildren?
I mean, if I can help it, because I got to do everything I need to ensure that, you know, we make new money. I don't really want to look at his past.
Yeah, but nothing like looking at the money that you know, to make sure it doesn't get divided up between Biddles and Burrows and Burrows, that law firm and accountants, that firm that you have.
Exactly.
You understand what I'm saying?
Oh, for sure.
There's nothing like tying up the old business.
It hasn't been an issue because it has.
Now, how are the siblings all getting along? Are you all a united front, or is there a sibling out there really fighting for part of dad's thing? You all are getting along fine?
Me and my brothers are fine. I don't know what's going on in the media, but we're fine.
No, nobody said anything. I haven't heard anything that you guys aren't getting along. I'm just asking general Wendy questions.
Yeah,
I mean, you know, I like to know things like this. You know what I'm saying?
For sure.
Because when people die, you know, true feelings do come out concerning those left behind.
Definitely.
I mean, Barry White's situation was disgusting. They said that there was a baby.
It
turned out not to be a baby. And, you know,
I guess it could be worse, because I look at the situation.
I've heard nothing about you guys.
And it could probably be worse.
Yeah.
I mean, there's some turmoil amongst the siblings, his siblings.
Rick, your father's brothers and sisters.
Of course.
Yeah, but they are not the next of kin. You are the next of kin. Why are they fighting?
They don't know that. I don't know.
Do you get along with your aunts and uncles?
I mean, we're okay, but, you know, I didn't come into my dad's life until I was maybe 12 or 13.
But you're still more, you're still from his loins. You're closer to him in terms of blood,
most
next
definitely.
Of kin than his grown, your aunts and uncles, his brothers and sisters.
Yeah, that's what we would like to believe.
Ty, how many attorneys do you have working for you and the siblings?
Probably just one or two. One or two people.
Uh-oh, you all.
Isn't that good?
We
need more.
Let me just talk to the audience for a minute.
I need help.
You all. Something tells me Ty is not on top of the situation at all. Them white people in the big offices about to rob the James kids blind.
If they know any good attorneys, have them call in.
No, Ty, no. This is New York. Although we are on in California on the beat. But by the time this show plays, all the attorneys' firms are closed. No, girl, no. Oh, I am nervous. I'm nervous for the whole family. Look, my palms are sweating like it's my money.
We'll be okay. I'm going to put it in God's hands. That's all I can do.
Child, please. God is busy with war-torn countries and the war. You know, he's not worried about the James kids.
He's going to look out for us. He got us.
Ooh.
Wendy, don't say that.
Okay, tell me about this.
You're making me nervous.
No, there's a need. All right, Art, is there a need for nervousness?
Yes.
Do you sense a little something going on in here?
Yes.
Like, we need to stop this interview now. You need to get back out to LaGuardia Airport, hop a plane, and handle your bit.
Oh, Wendy.
Girl. So who's your mother to Rick? Were they ever married? Were they?
They weren't married. Seville is my mom, but she had me and my little brother.
Yeah.
So basically, they had two kids together.
Yeah. So he was in love with her, apparently.
Oh, yeah.
And
that's undoubtedly.
And they lived together.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Seville, that sounds like a showbiz name. Was she one of the background singers, dancers, roadies?
No, she's a designer as well.
Nice.
So both of my parents are artists, which is kind of hard.
Yeah.
You can imagine, but.
Well, that explains you've got a very unique look yourself. Very rock and roll. And when I say that, everybody, I don't mean a backhanded comment. I mean, she's rock and roll. She's gone on denim from head to toe. Her jeans are splashed with paint. She's got on the furry mucklucks, a girl after my own heart, and the blonded out hair and the whole bit. Very rock and roll. But back to the movie about your father's life. Okay, so we talked about Terrence Howard. You would love for Terrence. No. I want to talk to you. Oh, okay. Sir, you can come back about the movie. When we get ready to do casting, trust and believe, the Wendy Williams experience, we've got a wealth of people who are dying to act and just always looking for opportunities. Whenever you do your casting calls, just let us know here, okay?
I'm just not on that end of it, though.
Okay, well...
I'm on the executive team.
Okay, the people on that end, just let them know. We'll help out. Now, do you speak to Tina Marie?
Tina and I don't really speak, no.
On a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the worst, I'm going to punch you in your face and hit you in the head with a champagne bottle, bitch. On a scale of 1 to 10, what's your relationship with Tina?
I would definitely say it's a seven, eight. I mean, we don't have any problems, but I think she has some hard feelings, and I don't really know what they're pertaining to. I guess his service, you know, a lot of people had issues with the way that I chose to do things, which was what I know he wanted.
What did you choose to do?
As far as his services.
Tell us.
My dad chose to be cremated. Mm-hmm. A lot of people felt like he should have been buried against his wishes, which that's not what I chose to do. Mm-mm. I mean, he said repeatedly that he didn't want a burial.
Now, your father, as I can recall, died suddenly. He hadn't been sick for a period of time.
No.
But you had this conversation with him. Because it's an important conversation, as painful as it is for a parent to have with the child.
And it was never serious, but I know my dad, when he says certain things jokingly,
right.
It's what he means.
That's right. I got what you're saying. Yeah. So where does Tina Marie get off with an opinion of how he should be handled like that? Now, I'm thinking that this might be money, but I'm thinking, Ty, that you might not see that. Was any money owed to Tina?
No, not at all.
Okay.
Actually, I think money was owed to my dad.
Okay. Were there special things like the ring from the 1976 tour, Tina Marie, Rick James World Tour? You know, were there things that perhaps she might have wanted that weren't given to her?
I don't think that was it either. I think that they had a certain relationship and she had a love for him and obviously he had one for her. And maybe she just had an opinion on how things should have been done.
Now, what is your mother's opinion of the estate of your late dad? Your mom, Seville. Now, she bore two of his three children. Mm-hmm. So clearly, even though you are an adult and your mom, Seville, wouldn't necessarily be in line, but perhaps there's enough. There was no will. Am I correct?
No, there was definitely a will and trust in place.
Okay, so what is the holdup now? What, like, for instance, in the will, how much were you to get? What were you to get? A ring and a vintage car?
No, Wendy. Basically, the will has been split between his children, and that
and there's
it.
Three of you.
Yeah, that was it. Nobody else was really included. I mean, he felt like he had three kids, and that's who was to receive anything that was to be gotten.
And I like that idea. I've got to talk to you more.
Okay.
Go relax. You can return your call. Use a landline. The service in here is terrible.
Okay.
And we'll be back with Ty James next.
Cool.
Wendy, man.
I met up with this guy. We were together. We were at his house. And why do you think his thing wouldn't work? Do you think maybe he's...
How you doing?
The Wendy Williams Experience. Yo, did you catch this flashback?
He gave a quote on the show, hope springs eternal to the human breast. I asked you if you had a radio show.
Drink
what it
deep
was...
or taste not of the Pierian stream.
Oh! Where does that come from, Daddy?
That's Alexander Pope.
Okay.
P-O-P-E.
And you see what I had to deal with? Do you see what I had to deal with growing up? I'm reading The Inquirer. He's reading the Alexander Pope, and she's over at Target.
This is it right here.
Miss a day, miss a whole lot.
Coming through your speakers, boy.
It's Wendy, man. Ty James is still in the studio with us. Hey, honey.
Hi.
Now, were you returning a phone call from one of your friends saying, leave the building now, leave the building now? People try to do that with my guests.
Really?
Did anybody know that you were coming up here who warned you?
I heard some things, Wendy, but I didn't let that...
Don't let it deter you.
Not at all.
It's not right.
I had the privilege of reading your book, and I was... pleased. I learned some things.
Everybody's has baggage. Hell, you know what I mean? Listen, do you ever check out the show On the Beat? It's on late night.
No,
right before Steve Harvey.
I've heard about it.
Yeah, a lot of people out there have been giving me some good feedback. It's usually when they're three sheets in the wind leaving the club, and then they turn on their radio and their eyes. Ty James, everybody, the oldest daughter of Rick James. No, the estate hasn't been settled. Yes, she's been here for, this is her second break, and you have missed quite a bit of information. Tina Marie has a daughter who's half black, half white. Is the father of perhaps your father?
Whoa, the answer to that is no, but I don't know who Aaliyah's father is.
Okay. How old is she?
Aaliyah's like maybe 10 or 11.
Okay, so not in your age range. I was going to ask you guys.
I'm not quite sure how old she is, honestly.
Okay, so I got wind that on the Chappelle show that they're not allowed to do Rick James, bitch. The estate got some type of court injunction. So Chappelle can't do the Rick James bitch, fresh Rick James material anymore?
Well, I'm not aware of that.
Oh, you don't know enough. You don't know enough for me. I don't feel comfortable.
Dave was going to do my dad's story, but my dad didn't want his life told in
a comic.
Comedic, you know.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, basically.
Okay, Gary's here also. Gary, you're the executive producer of the forthcoming Rick James story. Now, did Dave Chappelle want to do the story prior to Rick? Here, do me a favor. Bring the mic back around to Gary's seat so he doesn't have to get up and share Ty's mic with as little noise as possible. Now, Paramount shut that down. Was that when Rick was actually alive, or was that after his death? Come on, with the microphone. This is only... Come on, faster. Bring it down. There you go.
It was actually before he passed, though, Wendy.
Right.
It was before he passed.
It was before he passed.
And they shut it down because they didn't want it to be told.
He didn't want
how do you know Chappelle's? How did your father know if Chappelle's range couldn't have been serious? Who would have thought Jamie Foxx could play a serious blind man?
They told him the idea that they had, and he was like, hell no.
Okay. So now, Gary, now you have you and your partners have the rights to the Rick James story.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And Ty, what did that cost?
Good relationships.
What about money? I'm trying to figure out where the money comes in. You know, you can't touch this alone is what? A multi-million dollar operation alone. Just that one song.
Gary, where did the money come from?
Gary, how are you making this movie?
We're going to finance it independently. And Lou Gossett Jr. he's heading the charge along with me.
You're looking for investors still?
We're looking for investors.
You got to be kidding me. Denzel, Eddie, Lou Gossett Jr., the estate of Rick James. You've got to be kidding me. You are out here peddling like a crack whore for money, for the rights to a man like Rick James's story?
No, we already have the story.
No, money to produce it.
Well, it's a process. You have to do the deals, Wendy.
Yeah.
You have to cut the contract.
But the estate...
$30 million.
I have a meeting on it. This is a big film.
That kind of money.
Okay.
We're looking at about a $40 million production.
I'm just a little shocked that, like, four black Hollywood heavyweights wouldn't get together.
Did nobody step to the plate?
Yeah, I'm a little...
I just got involved. So now that I've gotten involved, things are... Stop that.
Okay, so Ty, are you an artist? Do you sing, you dance, you rap?
I'm working on my project.
Yeah. What do you do? You sing, you rap. Okay, uh-huh. Get some headphones immediately. Immediately, get off the cell phone.
I got her single around here somewhere.
No. We need a fat beat.
Oh, no doubt.
And she's got the slick hook.
Uh-oh,
we about to get it on.
Oh, yeah.
Up in here. Hurry, hurry, hurry.
Wendy, you are crazy.
Only because it's only a 4-hour show.
Right.
And there's no script on the show or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
And I just looked around. And Regina was over there on her cell phone.
Yeah.
Playing a game.
Yes.
Zoe's knee deep in the National Enquirer.
Oh, my
God. No, I'm just playing. Zoe was doing the right thing. Regina. Can we have some headphones? Can we use your headphones? Are there no headphones? I don't believe this is a multi-million dollar operation.
All right, but we need hustle.
Yeah,
yes.
This break is about to be over. Now, she's had too much time to think about her rhyme, so I know your rhyme's going to be... Come on, Reg. Come on, Reg.
Business fit, nothing on the air.
Come on, Reg. Get it in.
I'm not to do this, guys.
All right, get him on her head.
BMC.
All right, now you organize them. And you got something nice over there, Artie?
Yes, I do. You ready?
All right, and three, Jesus. And two, and
that's
one.
Crazy.
Ooh, come on.
Come on now.
I won't look at you. That way, don't look at her because you'll make her nervous. Come on,
y'all,
I know you're
16. I'm going to give it. Well, yeah. I ripped 16s. I was born for this. Big ups to my ladies on the pole, dropping their ass for a quick tip. 26, 34, 32 in the hips. In the VIP, blowed with a bottle of Crisp. I got that ice that could light your life. Keep a 9 in my bag just in case you think twice. Game over, you ain't no. Tell a friend, it's only so long fake thugs can pretend. Just when you thought it was Hove. What?
What?
I give you 8. How was that? 8, 10?
Well, so when'd you see it? That was Rick James' daughter. Yeah, clap it up. Show some respect to the legacy of the legend, at least. When's your CD going to be projected? And who are you signed with?
Basically, we're just finishing up the CD now. I'm going to drop a single probably the same time my dad's single drops, which is in August. So
yes, that would
I'm
be...
trying to promote both at the same time.
Okay, so that would be the CD, idea. Everybody. It's called the...
My album's called Addicted to the Game.
And your father's...
And my dad's is called Rick James Forever.
Bitch. Yes. Can't wait for that.
It's going to be hot.
But the good thing about the estate and the way things have gone so far is you guys have remained low under the radar, out of the news. You're not on Entertainment Tonight. Family's not fighting all up in the pages of In Touch
That's
magazine.
Important.
And this show knows nothing about anything nasty going on in the background regarding the estate. The bad thing in my mind is that it doesn't seem like anybody knows that much about when the money's all... I mean, for real, it's not even like, well, Wendy, she's probably just trying to keep you out of her business. No, it just it seems like, damn, well, you know what? I wish you well. And I know I'm going to see you around more. Everybody, keep listening to this show for details on casting and how far we're going with the Rick James movie.
Yes.
Ty, thank you for coming in. Gary,
thanks for having
we'll
us.
Talk.
Thank you.
Wendy, man.
I just found out this morning that my supervisor's pregnant.
Damn you, I told you not to do it.
Should I tell my wife what's up?
Plan on a divorce. And as for your job, put that where? Back there.
The Wendy Williams Experience.
Yo, did you catch this flashback?
I was thinking pearls would be the next big thing for men. You know, you got the pink shirts, right? You throw some ice on a gangster medallion and put it on a string of, you know, 36-inch pearls.
Well, Andre 3000 wears them on his wrist.
Well, I know he does, but I'm talking about just throw them on the neck. And they come in pink, they come in blue, they come in white. You know what I'm saying? Right. Nice pearl necklace for all you gay rappers.
How you doing?
Miss a day, miss a whole lot.
Coming through your speakers, boy.
It's Wendy, man.
For shizzle, I'm saying if Michael Jordan had $10 million, right, and Denzel was good for, well, tons, but would ante up $5 million, you know, Bill Cosby for $5 million, $3 million, whatever. The point that I'm making is it's a damn shame that they can't get this Rick James story done quite yet. And what's even more of a shame is I got the feeling that the kids aren't going to get anything much, what they deserve, what their father intended. You know, I think that there's a whole bunch of office of suits. And Ty, his daughter, was not lying. Behind the scenes, she was like, really, Wendy, if you know a good estate attorney, you know, in California, please let me know. Because everybody thinks that they can do estate law, but it's a whole nother animal. But I'm like, I can't believe it. Like, I was just stunned, that's all. Look, let's move on. We got bigger fish to fry. Ty, thanks for coming in, though. We love your pop. We love his memory. Give me the typewriter. I'm just sick. I am just sick. Why are they putting us through this, Oprah and Steady? Speculation and rumors. We talked about this last week. I can't believe that I'm still dealing with this. That Oprah Winfrey has a child flew yesterday after she dropped a bomb in a tease for an upcoming show. The talk show queen shocked her legions of fans yesterday by saying that on Monday she would reveal, next Monday I guess, a deep dark family secret about her and her longtime beau Stedman Graham. Here's the quote. Stedman and I have a daughter, she confessed in a clip. She has issues, and I think it's my fault. Oh, Art. Fans have long hoped Oprah and Stedman, a motivational speaker and author, would have a child together in the belief that they'd make perfect parents. There was speculation a couple of years ago in a British tabloid that they were shopping for a surrogate mom, but the reports... Is that... I was going to say, because I know if they have a child, it ain't from Oprah's coochie. there was speculation a couple of years ago. Okay. And Oprah watchers say no mom scenarios are likely for the megastar who hasn't been out of the public eye long enough to go through pregnancy. That's why I said what I said. And while the couple maintains super secrecy about their private lives, it's also unlikely that they became adoptive or foster parents on the QT, watchers say. Unless the whole thing is a publicity stunt. I think it's a publicity stunt, but you know what I think she's going to announce? One of the girls from the school in Africa, they adopted, and now the little girl is about to get out of high school, say, and come over here and go to the University of whatever in California where Oprah is relocating, and the girl's going to take a job apprenticing on her show or something like that. Whatever this is, Oprah, you really don't need to go through such a stretch to tease a show. I mean, this really stoops to the level of the experience. I mean, really. A tease like this? Come on now. Unless she's going to say that she adopted Stedman's daughter, Wendy, back when they first started dating. Because Wendy is like 23 right now. You got to figure Oprah and Stedman started dating like 17 years ago. The girl was, you know, an adolescent, probably would love to have had a mother figure. She and Steady were in love. So Oprah adopted Wendy. I'm not buying too much into it. About Mariah Carey and Jennifer Lopez. Well, couldn't you just figure? Don't you remember when Mariah was here and I asked her about Jen? And she said, well, Wendy, what label? Mariah led me through a whole maze with questions. What label is Lopez on? I said, Sony. Who is her boss? I said, Mottola, you know, at the time. I don't know. Is he still there? I don't know. I lose track.
He's not.
Whatever.
He's Usher's manager now.
Okay. Well, who is her boss? I said, your ex-husband, Mottola. I said, and what good do you think he could get out of? And I said, oh, well, you know, pitting against his ex-wife, of course, because even though you all were married, you've now turned into, you know, that bitch, probably to him. And he prays for your I won't say downfall, but you know what I mean. She said, exactly, Wendy, case closed. So I'm not buying into it. But I see in one of my favorite magazines, In Touch. Hey, In Touch. So they have an article saying that Mariah looks stunning at her Emancipation of Mamie party, which I couldn't go to because I had to finish my own CD. Damn, I wish I went to this party. Puffy rushed up to embrace her. Jay-Z, Denzel, la la la. Mariah is back. Ba 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 ba. The fact that Benny Medina, the man behind J-Lo's initial success, worked with Mariah on the album must make it hard for Jennifer. Yeah, well, I'm sure it does, but Jennifer's no longer with him, so life must go on for Benny Medina. The two have been feuding for years. When a journalist told Mariah that she had just met J-Lo, the diva snipped, I bet that was intellectually stimulating. Yeah, she made a comment about J-Lo being stupid when she was here also. But she didn't say anything more. It might have been that exact quote. I bet you that was intellectually stimulating. Yeah, like something like that. I say this, though. I love both of them for virtually the same reason. Fabulousness. I could give a rat's behind about who can authentically sing or not. However, Jennifer, you cannot hold a candle to the vocal stylings of one Mariah Carey. But zhuzhed up in the studio, who gives a damn? They make you sound good as far as I'm concerned, Jen Lo. And Mariah... Jen Lo's got nothing on your boobs, but you got nothing on that ass. Both of yous are great in your own rights. I'm not going to even feed into the feud. So that's my commentary on it. I love them both for the very same reason, yet two different reasons. Both of them have been close to Puffy at one point or another. Who's the more authentic beauty? Well, you both have had work done on your faces. So, and I don't think that there's anything wrong with it, but just let the record show. That's my opinion, by the way. You look at the noses. Nose for nose, both noses have been done. Mariah, Mimi, that new chin is looking awfully cute. Jen, your first nose still needed judging. You got it done again. It looks cute. Tasteful. Neither one of you are in the hood now, baby. I mean, both, you know, everything is tasteful on both your broads. And both, you know, liposuction, as far as I'm concerned. Why are you wowing? What is the big deal?
It's not a big deal.
Well, then stop starting something by wowing.
Sorry.
I couldn't picture either one of you having sex crazily. You, the two of you and Beyonce, you fan your hair out and ask, keep asking a man, what's my name, what's my name? Aren't you glad to be with me? That's what all three of yous do, as far as I'm concerned. The three of yous play like you can put it down, but I don't believe nothing is really popping off. Why are you ooing? Egging it on.
Sorry. I got the record needed.
Regina, can you fix... Can you picture Jennifer Lopez... No, this. The mic. Regina. Can you picture Jennifer Lopez all wild and crazy and sweaty? I mean, for real? And be honest, don't agree. Regina, you must work faster.
Okay.
Yes, I can, because she's one of the wild Latins, yes.
Okay, so you're stereotyping.
Okay.
Mariah Carey, do you picture that hair whipping all around and, you know, lipstick smeared all over? And
No, not her.
Okay. No. Beyonce, what do you see all doing there when the lights go out?
At times, I can see her getting at certain peaks of getting wild, but no, not generally wild.
I'm talking about down on the ground like the Crazy Love video. Did you see that?
Oh, no, she's not.
To me, that's all an act.
It's an act. That's
okay. All right. Just so we're clear. And if I had to choose between the three of them, which one puts it down the hardest, I would have to say probably Jen. Yeah. Because in the Fabulous video, when she catches the beat in her little jacket and her little hood wear, and she's popping her body, I'm like, okay, maybe. Just maybe. Beyonce, I don't care how many times you pop it, it's all an act to me. And Mariah, you move your shoulders. So, you know, it is what it is, Mimi. I love all three of you broads. The Game wants to collaborate with Ice Cube. Boy, I love him. Game says, I don't have time to go over what Game says. Really, I'm looking at the clock. I'm feeling like the show is over and we just got here. Princess said, Wendy, cold feet is one thing, but faking a kidnapping, cutting your hair, buying a bus ticket a week in advance, saying a Latino did it is quite another. Mm-hmm. I hear what you're saying, Princess. Look, let's move on. Do we have the Jackie O record?
Yes, we do.
Okay, well, let's hit that.
Okay, let me get it for you.
Look, well, I'm not playing this whole record either. I was listening to it while it was in production, and, well, I'll let you all listen to it.
Okay, here we go.
This is Jackie O dissing Foxy.
Mm-hmm. TKO.
Okay.
Uh-huh? TKO.
It's called TKO. Okay, hit it, Jackson. Don't turn off my mic.
Unusual Suspects.
Okay.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you don't ask for trouble. Sometimes yeah. Trouble just come to you. This how I feel about trouble. Yeah.
Just prepare for your departure, cause I ain't squashing. We can get it on the floor. We can empty quicker. How you coming down south? Trying to check. You ain't gotta like me, but you gon' respect me. Motherfucker Fox, whack. I'm a hunter, set by the minute tracks, and you just a runner. I didn't want to jack ya, but how your man let ya? Come to 305 and run up on the chin checker. I damn near gave your classes the asthma attack. Smack it down and kick chain ya. How you got another deal when your lyrics ain't real? Whoever goes writing need to help you write your will. Capitalize on what? Ain't wanna contend with ya. Honest anger? I don't think nobody remembers ya. Fox Bozo, Foxy Clown, Foxy Cotton or Jello. I wanna see who the hell is the Geppetto. How y'all bought that?
Back, throwback.
Wait, all right, turn it back up.
Tell your ghost rider, turn down his headnet. You already know what the track is. Just prepare for your departure, cause I ain't squashing. We can get it on the floor, we can empty. How you coming down south?
Okay, just my opinion. Stop. Just my opinion. Foxy, you's a crazy broad. You's got a lot of nerve for going down there and doing what you did. And she served you up probably exactly what you've been asking for from somebody. But I do have to say this. You could kill her in your 16. Kill it, Foxy. Yo, Foxy.
Be easy on her, Foxy.
Foxy, be easy, please. Get her. You know, it's not like Foxy doesn't have something with her swagger. It's just the way she does it. It's, you know, all crazy and wild like. But Foxy, the path is free. It's clear. We are ready for you to land all over that. What was that? The cadence alone. ABC.
He was just shouting you out because you broke Sunshine before everyone was playing, and he said after you played it, the whole country started.
Of course!
The Wendy Williams Experience.
Another WBLS $1,000 winner.
Hello!
Hello, Wendy!
Hi!
How you doing?
Good. And you're caller number 10.
I am.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
You just got $1,000. WBLS cash, that's your portion of our $100,000 cash guarantee.
Oh, that's great. Thanks very much. I appreciate it.
So, everybody else, your next chance to win is tomorrow morning at 7:20 with the WBLS Morning Show. Hey, sir, what's your name?
My name is Howard Flam.
And where are you calling from, Hal?
East Norwich, New York.
Well, I'm glad that you listened and let everybody know the only radio station with the $100,000 cash guarantee.
107.5 WBLS.
Yo, did you catch this flashback?
The fashion show started like a half hour late. Okay, so the next thing you know, it's Vivica Fox. Oh. Four seats down, I lie to you not. So she said, hi. She said, I just wanted to introduce myself to you. You know, I said, hi, Vivica, how are you? I said, actually, we ran into each other in L.A. I didn't go into what it was, but it was when you were dropping it like it's hot in front of my husband at Janet Jackson's party. You know what you were doing. It was like West Side Story out in that mother father. This is it right here.
Miss a day, miss a whole lot.
Coming through your speakers, boy.
It's windy, man.
A lawsuit was filed on April 28th in New York State Supreme Court by songwriters Anthony Jeffries Hart. They said songwriters, but it's one person with three names. I don't get it. Ow. Claiming that Little Kim owes both men. Wait, let me just say the songwriters. Anthony Jeffries Hart. Okay, that sounds like one person to me, but let me continue on. That Little Kim owes both men for their creative contribution on her 2003 album, La Bella Mafia. According to the court documents here in New York, obtained by Celebrity Justice on the case again. Jeffries and Hart are seeking $100,000 in damages. They say they were hired by Little Kim to help her write the tracks, Hold It Down, Can You Hear Me Now, and The Jump Off. The suit also charges that the duo was commissioned to provide vocals for the song Beehive. Now, according to the lawsuit, Jeffries and Hart were promised $15,000 each for their work, but Kim never made good on the agreement. The lawsuit alleges that compensation was eventually offered December of 2002 in the form of jewelry valued at $100,000. At $10,000. But court documents claim that not even 7 months later, Kim demanded that the pair return the jewels under a threat of physical violence. Kim? In addition to the lawsuit for breach of contract, both guys are claiming that they made several in-store promotional appearances with Little Kim to support the album. Again, they say they were never paid for their work. Kim was convicted on March 17th, as we know, boom, 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 and she's scheduled to be sentenced on June 24th. There's probably a bit of truth in what they're saying. I can even believe that Kim would offer jewelry and then ask for it back. But she's got bigger fish to fry at this particular point. She's not concerned with you, and I'm not even concerned with your story. You know what I'm saying? June 24th is Kim's sentencing day. Let's move on, because I made a whole lot of promises, and I have two more to fulfill before this show is over. I promised you I'd talk to you about Paris Hilton. Okay, real quick. Are her eyes brown or blue, naturally? They're naturally brown. I've actually seen her natural eyes before in pictures. But she wears blue contacts. Now, here's the explanation. According to this, Paris spends close to $100,000 a year to keep those blue eyes blue. She dropped $17,000 the other day on 100 pairs of tinted blue contacts to turn her dark brown natural eyes a vibrant shade of blue. Now, why is it that we make fun of little Kim and Oprah and Marion then when they wear the contacts, but nobody says anything about Paris Hilton? Is it because they look more natural because it's a white girl? But Oprah's, I always thought, looked very tasteful in their. Although I was always shocked at Opie, you know, of all things. I was shocked that she... Yeah, she used to wear... light brown.
Yeah.
That used to shock me. Like, yeah. Mary still wears hers. Kim wears hers now and then, but Oprah, of all of them, just was most shocking to me. But yeah, apparently, this Paris Hilton goes through sometimes like a pair a day. You know, they either fall on the floor, they scratch or whatever, you know, she loses them. She goes through like a pair a day, and they sell for approximately $170 a pair. And one of the favorite places that she likes to go get them is a place in the Beverly Center, where she purchases, they say, about 100 pairs every other month. Just to, because she rarely goes, like, she's really passing it off, like, these are her eyes. Well, I guess not, because we all know, but she was attempting to, I guess, prior to this. All right, look, there's no rhyme or reason in explaining, in my own words, what is going on with LaDonna Fredericks, Lamont Bentley's baby's mother, who was not awarded a dime, but her two children from Lamont Bentley got $7.2 million apiece. And then Lamont's mother got $7.2 million. The $21.6 million. Somebody had the nerve to fax me. I'm still irked by this and say, F Lamont Bentley. Don't nobody know who that is. Why are you spending so much time on talking about Lamont Bentley? Hakeem from Moesha, I just passed that off as being a person that did not know of what they were speaking. I'm enthralled in this trial. I'm surprised that LaDonna Fredericks, the baby's mother, is still jumping up. Give me the typewriter.
Okay.
The best way I can explain it is to read it. Judge Tamara Wilkes Burke, that's the judge on the case, y'all, delivered some unexpected news to LaDonna Fredericks yesterday that had Ms. Fredericks crying again, inconsolably, in her boyfriend Tevon Frazier's arms. Ms. Fredericks and her attorney, as well as LaJoyce Underwood, Lamont's mother, and her lawyer met at Judge Wilkes' chambers yesterday to finalize the allocation of Lamont Bentley's $21.6 million estate. Judge Wilkes Burke commended the jury for a job well done, adding that since Lamont's daughters, Brazil 11 and Artesia 9, were minors, Ms. Underwood, Lamont's mother, would be the executor of the will. In other words, LaDonna won't get her mitts on not one thin dime, one plug nickel. Facing the press, Judge Wilkes Burke said, "The ruling shouldn't be surprising to Ms. Fredericks at all. Her attorney should have reminded her that the California probate court stipulates that if minors are involved..." Now, hold on. Before I read the rest of this, I thought that the major next to the minor would be in charge.
Yeah.
LaDonna Fredericks is the major next to the minor. Mm-hmm. I thought she would be in charge of each of the girls' 7.2. Yeah. So I'm a little shocked by this, too. But I'll press on. The surviving adult... Oh, crap! You gotta be kidding me! Watch how we're gonna start off tomorrow's show. I'm gonna take a pill first thing when I wake up in the morning. And the first break of tomorrow's show, we're gonna continue right where we left off. I'm marking the page. I'm making myself a note to take my memory pill. And we'll be back tomorrow. I love you for listening today. All right, bye.
Peace, party people. See you later.
Cause I'm saying bye-bye.
Good night.
Program complete.
Now you know my special tri-state people. We will not wait until tomorrow to luxuriate in this conversation. We'll talk about LaDonna, Lamont, Paula Abdul. Let me see. Oh my gosh, I've got to share with you some of the emails I've gotten of people who want to date Carlos. Let me see. This just in from the other office. OfficialRickJamesMovie.com. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Bianca. I want to talk with you about Carmen Electra and her new deal. I got to take your phone calls. I got a few really great letters left over from Advice Hour that I wanted to... Just a whole bunch of crap. You know how the bonus hour is. Okay, it is what it is. It starts in exactly 10 minutes right here on 107.5 WBLS. Thanks.